Alright, let's continue on with rigging. Rigging gives the mesh a frame or support structure to allow for posing and movement. Just like human skeleton, rigs either hold the model in place or moves it. Once a model is rigged, I can always reset and pose or even animate it using layers. Let's go back to where we stopped in the tutorial and delete the bounding boxes. Click to select each bounding box and delete them. How should I pose the model? I want the arms to get out of the way so that they will not interfere with dynamics feature later on. It should be a simple rig where I can just raise the arms, leaving all the other parts of the body in place. This method of rigging is only used for models with one subtool. Unlike some models which contain multiple subtools, Transpose Master will help transform all the other subtools to match the rigged model. However, in this tutorial, I'm not going to use Transpose Master, just rigging one subtool with ZSphere. See how the swimming suit matches the pose of the body using Transpose Master? Now, let's prepare Julie's body subtool for rigging. Check the subdivision levels under Geometry. At the highest level, there should be 1.4 million active points. At subdivision level 5, click on Mac Polymesh 3D to extract just the body subtool. What I have here is only the highest subdivision of Julie's body subtool, without all the lower subdivisions. So I'm going to regenerate the lower subdivisions, go under Geometry, then Reconstruct Subdivision. Click until you reach about 5,000 active points. When rigging, low subdivision is easier to rig, and it keeps ZSphere's numbers low. After rigging the low subdivision mesh, the rig can then be transferred to a more detailed high-resolution mesh. But why can't we rig a high-resolution mesh directly, and what's the difference between rigging a high-resolution mesh and a low-resolution mesh? Take, for example, this Julie model with a high-resolution swimming suit mesh. The number of points are so high that when I rig the model with a basic skeletal layout, the low number of Z-spheres are unable to hold the dense swimming suit mesh. So more Z-spheres would be required to hold the swimming suit mesh in place. While this low subdivision mesh with only about 1,000 active points, rigged with the same number of Z-spheres and layout, can hold and move the mesh without affecting the swimming suit. There are no unwanted artifacts pulled off by the arm Z-spheres at the waist or armpit. For the dense swimming suit mesh, I had to add another two sets of Z-spheres. One at the waist and one at the armpit, just to hold the swimming suit and straps in place. It is the same concept as the lower the resolution, the wider the area affected by a single point. So low resolution requires less Z-spheres to handle the points. The higher the resolution, the smaller the area affected by a single point. So more Z-spheres will be needed to hold and move the mesh. Why not increase the size of the Z-spheres instead? A large Z-sphere here being pulled upwards compared to a small Z-sphere, the result is relatively similar. At the moment, it doesn't make a difference. Now that we understand how rigs work using Z-spheres, let's switch the active tool to Z-sphere and start rigging. Add in the mesh I want to rig, go under Rigging, click on Select Mesh, and click on PM3D_Julie. You will see a transparent low resolution Julie extracted and resized previously. Now let me introduce you to the four keys needed to control Z-spheres. Q to draw, W to move, E to scale, and R to rotate. Usually I just place my fingers over these keys and switch between the fingers. pinky finger to draw, ring finger to move, middle finger to scale, and pointer finger to rotate. Alternatively, control key can be used to switch between these buttons. Draw out a Z-sphere, then press Shift to snap to the previous size. Press Alt and tap on Z-sphere to delete. Alt Delete only works when draw mode is on. Draw another Z-sphere, press Shift to snap. Press and hold Control to switch from draw mode to move mode. Without lifting the stylus after drawing, drag right to move Z-sphere to the right. Without lifting the stylus again, re-press Control to switch to scale mode. Drag down to scale down, drag up to scale up. Let's do this one more time, this time drawing a long chain. Draw a new Z-sphere, snap to size, press Control, drag right. Release all and repeat. Drag downwards to draw, Shift to snap, Control to switch to move. Repeat these steps to draw more. There's another interesting way to draw using Control button. Draw out a single Z-sphere, then press Control 3 times without lifting your pen. You can go wild and draw a 3D bezier line freely. Z-spheres will be added in between the chains automatically. On top of that, it's pressure sensitive, so the harder you press, the bigger the Z-spheres are. The lighter you press, the smaller the Z-spheres are. The different colors are the different polygroups incorporated into the Z-sphere chains after each change of size. In this tutorial, I'm going to use the simple QWER method, nothing too wild. Now that we know three ways to add and manipulate Z-spheres, let's start rigging from the neck. Press E to scale, click center, and drag up to scale down. Press W to move. Press E to scale again. Zoom in, Control, right click, hover right. Press W to move it slightly. Press X to turn on symmetry. Q to draw, but the draw size is too big, so the two brushes are overlapping. Change the draw size to 1. Now they are not overlapping. Click and drag to add two symmetrical Z-spheres. Press Shift to snap to the previous size and W to move. Q to draw, Shift to snap, W to move. Q to draw, Shift to snap, W to move. Q to draw, Shift to snap, W to move. E to scale. Another Z-sphere to the hand. X to turn off symmetry, W to move. Q to add, Shift to snap, W to move. R to test out rotating the arms. Moving the arms without shoulder joint looks unnatural. Try moving the shoulder chain. Looks okay. Let's try moving it with the mesh. Go under rigging, click on bind mesh. Oops, press X to deactivate symmetry. It works fine, except the body and legs are moving together with the arm. The body needs its own rigging to hold the mesh. Press Q to draw, Shift to snap, W to move. Pull out a spine chain to the hip. Press Q to draw, X to activate symmetry. Shift to snap, W to move. Check from the side. Q to add, Shift to snap. New joints for the buttocks. Move the hip joint backwards to support the buttocks. Repeat the same process until you reach the feet. Press R to rotate. Test out rotating the hip Z-spheres. Rotate to the front and back. Try with mesh, rigging, bind mesh, front and back. Arms, the chest area needs more support to hold the mesh. Let me add some more Z-spheres at the chest area. Oops, I forgot to unbind mesh. Go under rigging, then click on bind mesh. Remember to unbind mesh after binding to edit Z-spheres. Alternate tap on joint to delete the Z-sphere added before unbinding mesh. Click again to add a joint between the chest. Press X for symmetry, Shift to snap, W to move. Move backwards to create a cage-like rib. Press Q, add more joints until a rib is formed. Press R to rotate, and now raising the arms shouldn't affect the body. Wrong joint. The shoulder joint looks more natural. Lightly tap to select either to rotate the joint or to rotate the chain. Let's generate a polymesh 3D with this pose. Adaptive skin, density 5. The same number as the number of subdivision levels. Slide down the Dynamesh resolution to 0 and click Preview or press A. Dynamesh can always be done after the new polymesh is generated. That's not necessary for now. This is the preview of a high resolution polymesh. The resolution is controlled by the density slider. Notice the active points are 1.4 million. The same as subdivision level 5 previously. All that's left to do is click on Make Adaptive Skin under Adaptive Skin tab. A high resolution polymesh 3D will be extracted and available for editing under Toolbox window. That's all for this rigging stage, but I'm going to continue on with Layers tutorial next, where I'm going to show you how to reset, record, and replay poses. I thought I could finish rigging and layers in one tutorial, but it seems like this video is getting way too long. If you like my tutorial, please give me a like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Adios!